Hi everybody, this is Connie, and welcome to another Get Ready With Me. I have quite a few, but a few videos to do today, and so I thought I would do a Get Ready With Me first, so I have some makeup on for the rest of them. Anyway, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to do my skincare. I don't do much. I washed my face this morning with anti-aging Yesta Blueberries face soap, and now I'm going to put my serum on, and this is Matrixyl 3000 serum from Timeless, and you can see where I mapped there already. This goes pretty fast, actually. Okay, and what I'm gonna do is I'm just going to squeeze this. It brings up about a half a deal of serum. I'm going to put that in the palm of my hand and then rub my fingers together and just see, I started out doing a whole dropper full, and then I would bring it down too, but that just, it goes so darn fast that a half of a dropper is plenty to do my face. So that is done. Now I'm going to use my eye cream, and this is Timeless Hydrating Eye Cream with Hyaluronic Acid and Matrixyl 3000. And I just do one pump in my hand and just take my finger and dab it in there and then just dab it under my eye, and I do it up around my eye and my eyelid. And I really haven't noticed anything from the eye cream. You know, I am not an expert on skincare. I am very new. I mean, this is the first stuff I have ever done, and I'm 61 years old. Then I just rub my hands together. It's not sticky or anything. Okay. Now we're going to let that dry. So this is going to be a little bit longer video. I will pause this and let Okay, I'm back. I am having a terrible hair day. I did color my hair yesterday, and I should have brought the box. I used the Garnier Nutrice, I think it's called, for the first time. I've never used that before. It's very easy to use, smelled fine. I don't know if my hair's as soft using that, though, as it is using my Nice and Easy, which I always use. But I do like the color. What do you think? Okay, for my primer today, I am going to use Master Prime by Maybelline, and this is the Blur and Redness Control 300, the green one. Let's shake this up a little, just in case. I haven't used it for a while. Excuse me, and I have got a cold, so really it hasn't gotten bad yet, but I've had this cough for about a week, and it's loosening up now where it sounds terrible, but what do you know, what do you do? Okay, today I'm going to use, I'm not real crazy about this one or the Milani one, but I want to use them both a couple more times before I decide to pass them on or whatever. And since it's a pump, you know, I'm not touching anything, so I could pass this on because it's full. But we're going to see. just put a couple pumps on the back of my hand. A little bit runny, you can tell that. And I'm going to use my dampened Real Technique sponge. Goes on pretty fast. I do not dab. Maybe I should. I see other people dabbing. I don't know. I don't feel like I'm pushing the stuff around. I think it is going on just fine, but I will dab if I'm supposed to dab. Really, I don't think that looks too bad today, so I don't know. I'll have to see how it lasts through the day. Anyway, back to my skincare. That's all I do in the morning. I wash my face, and one thing I forgot to do, though, is put my lotion on after my eye cream. Too late now. I'm not going to take everything off. I'm going to use, for my brows today, I'm going to use the Giordano FabuBrow Shape and Set in this is dark brown. And I think it's separating, and I tried to shake it a lot, but I don't know if it's doing any good. This is too dark. I'm not going to wear it this week to work. Oh, come on. Somebody showed this in a video this week that you're supposed to go kind of back and forth. Not supposed to do that. I tell you, this is kind of clumpy. And I don't think it's too dark. But you can see this okay. Yeah, it's pretty clumpy. You go over them again, it darkens them. But I don't have a lot of eyebrow on this side, and I can never get them, ever get them so they look alike. I know somebody complained one time, and you know what she can do. Not that I don't, you know, it's that she was kind of mean. Kimmy stood up for me, though. All right, today I'm going to use, for something different, I'm going to use the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion. And I squeezed it really good, so hopefully still kind of watery. I don't know. I see other people using this and that works just fine. Mine's just kind of watery. And I shook it and squeezed it and I don't know. I'm going to continue to use it, though, because this is what I'm going to use after I'm done with my other. All right, eyeshadow. Now, this here, and I hope you guys will continue watching, I don't believe this is real. I got it off of Amazon, and I got it for like $20, I think it was. And I think these are more expensive than that. I'll have to look it up. So I don't know if this is the original or if it's a fake one. But I'll tell you what, the colors in this, I swatched them before I started today just to see if I wanted to use it. And they are really, really soft and buttery. So I don't know. But anyway, it's a Zoeva. I'm not sure. Rose Golden palette. And this is, it doesn't have a mirror. These are the colors. They're absolutely gorgeous. So anyway, I'm going to use it. You know, if it's a fake one, so be it. You know, I really don't care as long as they work. And some of them work, some of them don't. All right. So I am going to use, let's see what color this is. Luster for base. They act like a high-end. Like you sure don't have to go in very much to get any color. I'm going to have to look this up, and I will leave the information down below. Okay. You know what? I'm going to have to, well, I'm going to go into Shining Bright. They're all, that's the only matte color in the whole thing. So I'm going to go into Shining Bright and do my transition, even though it's a little shimmery. It's really pretty. Yeah, you can tell it's shimmery. But, oh well, for today, who cares? I'm just winging it. Okay, and I'll show you. This was Luster. This is, what did I call that? Shining Bright. Now I'm going to go in with this color, which is Copper is King for my brow, or for my lid. Oh, my goodness. It is absolutely gorgeous. This is just like butter going into it. Well, if this isn't real, it's a pretty dang good palette. I want a little bit more color. Let's go in with this. It's hard to read these colors. First off, Golden Rule. And just do a tiny, tiny bit in the center. I don't know if it's even going to show up. that didn't show up very well. Well, my hair is kind of transitioning right now. Last time I got it cut, I let her layer it, which was fine. But I have to wear my hair back in a ponytail every day because I wear a hairnet all day. And so half of it I got a pin because it won't go back to the ponytail. And so I decided, you know, I couldn't really afford to go have my hair cut. So I decided just to let my bangs grow. I'd love to hear from you. Should I cut my bangs? You know, remember what I looked like in bangs. Or should I let them grow? I would let them grow at least down to here, probably. Right now they're down to here. I would let them grow probably down to here. I don't know for sure. But let me know, you know, so they're kind of transitioning, so they look kind of bad right now. Anyway, all right, so I used this color and these two colors, and then I dabbed on this in the center. I do want to go in with my brush and just make sure there's no sharp lines there. All right, and there you go. I think it's gorgeous. I think it's really pretty. All right, for my mascara. And it comes in a case that I just keep it in, and you slide it in, and there's the case. It's got the Zoeva, I think is the name. Rose Golden. Rose Golden is the name of it. No parabens, no mineral oils, no fragrances. No phthalates, superior pigmentation, easy to blend with vitamin E made in Italy. Excuse me. All right, I'm going in with my the Falsies Push-Up Drama. And this is new. I got it out of my drawer. I'm switching out a few things. I'm going to be doing a huge declutter. I've already started on my lipsticks. It's wet, that's for sure. And clumpy. First impressions. Don't think I'm impressed. It's going all over my eyelid. And it just feels kind of heavy. I don't know. Feels kind of weird, actually. This one doesn't seem to be. Boy, it feels just heavy on my lids. It does. I can feel it on my lids. That's weird. Okay. So my eyes are done. Well, do I want to wear a... I like to go in with that brown that I used last week. Yeah, it was a Scandalize waterproof coal Rimmel in 003 brown. I kind of like that. Doesn't go into the water lines real good. There we go. Just kind of light, not too deep. All right. With my... I didn't get a powder out, though. I do want to... This drawer is in transition, so it's sticking. Okay, so let's do the Rimmel powder today. I'm going to put this on first, though, and I'm not going to put as much on as I normally do because I got a little carried away, and it's a little bit hard to I'm going to use my little Real Techniques for my concealer. This is damp, by the way, in case I forgot to tell you that. All right, let's go in with a powder. And I'm using the Stay Matte by Rimmel. Real Techniques brush, which I absolutely love. Bud. Here, honey, I'll move stuff for ya. Okay. Put those away. All right. And I don't know if I'm pretty sure I hauled this. I can't remember. But I am going to use my Laura Geller Baked Gelato Pink Vivid Flower Blush Pink Dahlia. I don't remember. I don't think I've ever used it. Isn't that absolutely gorgeous? You know, I love me some flower blushes. This isn't Milani, but it'll do. Okay. Highlighter, I'm going to use my Makeup Revolution Vivid Baked Highlighter in Peach Lights. Pretty too. And I'm going to use my lip liner, my Ulta Beauty lip liner in nude. So creamy. I like to do my whole lips, so. Man, that's a pretty nude. Can wear that all by itself. That's what I said with the last one I used. I have the hiccups. I'm sorry. Okay, and for my lips today, I am going to use the Revlon HD in 710 Desert something. It's too little for me to read. HD Desert. And it's like this, and I've worn this once before. This is a new lipstick I got recently. I like the smell of these. They smell kind of sweet and flowery, maybe. Okay, guys, there is my makeup of the day. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me bring you in a little bit farther now since I'm not in the mirror and you can see it up close. I think it's very pretty. So I will talk to you later. Bye-bye.